world's first bionic superhumans. They're stronger than us, faster, smarter. The next generation of the human race is...
Living in my basement?
Howdy, Scorpions. I'm Nehemiah, and just like you, I'm ready to go home, and I have been so since first period. Leading campus news today, as if you pay attention to it, for seniors, the spring scholarship bulletin has been updated. There are various local scholarships that are due soon. You are encouraged to apply. Also for seniors, if you want to participate in graduation in a memorable way, you have the chance to do so by singing or speaking during the ceremony. My advice is to keep it short. People have things to do. Try out in the activities office. Grad night tickets are now on sale, $130 with an activities card and $140 without. I sure hope it's worth it. Last day to purchase is April 21st. Now to take up more of your class time, because why not, we go to an all-new Wagner Report.
Excuse me. Madam. Madam. Hey, so... Can you explain to me how many vice presidents we have? Vice principals?
No.
Okay. Can you tell me who SpongeBob's pet is?
Pet?
Yeah.
Yes.
Who is it?
Gary the snail.
Thank you. So, can you name a United States senator?
Oh, no.
No.
Name as many Kardashians as you can.
Kardashian, Kim Kardashian, Khloe Kardashian,
Kendall.
That's Jenner. No, what's her name? Courtney.
Oh, yeah, Courtney.
Chloe, Kim, Robert. Courtney, okay. Robert.
And the mom, what's her name? Chris.
Chris, that's Jenner.
I think that's all.
And can you, who was Barack Obama's vice president?
Joe Biden.
Equally. Okay, so who's the governor of California?
Governor of California. Yum.
Who is SpongeBob's boss?
Mr. Krabs.
Thank you.
I like yours.
Hey, Chief. So,
Chief, I like that.
Who was governor before Gavin Newsom?
Are we recording?
Yeah.
Before Newsom? Jerry. Is his name Jerry?
I think that's the funniest thing you'll see in this broadcast.
We interrupt this program for an important news announcement.
School-wide testing will begin on Tuesday, April 11th. All 11th grade students will be taking an English, math, and science test for their state test. We want to encourage everyone to get a good night's rest the night before and eat a healthy breakfast the morning of their test. For added motivations, there are a couple incentives for the CASP. Students will receive a 5% grade bump for meets expectations. Students who exceed expectations will receive a 10% grade bump. As an added bonus, students who get a combined score of 8 or more on all three tests will earn a movie or bowling trip. And lastly, any student who scores a 10 or more on all three tests will receive a VIP homecoming ticket. You heard that, a VIP ticket with front of the lines access for homecoming. This is your chance to show what you know. Show the test who's boss.
Prom is this Saturday. Hope you all have fun, even if you're going alone. Speaking of those who are still alone, Ben and Sosa went around campus asking whether or not some things in people are red or green flags.
They have multiple phones. Is it a red flag or a green flag?
Red flag. Definitely.
Never mind.
Okay, honestly, it depends though. Because if they have like a business or something, they kind of get it.
They could use that. They could use one phone for that.
True. A red flag or a green flag that they wear flip-flops all the time?
Oh, that's okay. Yeah.
They have an Android.
I got an Android, so that's definitely a green flag.
Listen to Ice Spice.
That's a red flag.
Yeah.
Oh, my fault.
Sorry. Your partner doesn't want you to work.
Red flag. You need money.
Money.
You need money.
They want to combine your guys' money.
Oh, that's a red flag.
So,
they go through your phone.
I'm gonna fight back. I can't let that happen. Nah. It's a red flag. Is that it?
Alright, they only drink soda.
That's a red flag. I don't like soda, so.
Alright. Hides their faces.
Yo, why is there two lines?
It's a red flag.
They lie about where they're at.
Red flag. Immediately, bro.
Is it?
They don't say.
They're not hydrated. They have a girl best friend.
It depends.
Yeah, it's like in the middle, kind of.
And just so you know, everyone in broadcast has red flags. Anyways, if for some reason you're interested in joining ASB next year, then go get an application from the activities office, room A4. For any ninth graders that want to be involved in future freshman events, go to room W7, Tuesdays at lunch. That brings us to highlights from our school's beloved Grease production. Enjoy! Great job, kids. Can't wait for next year's. Now to more things that don't pique your interest even remotely. The Photo and Art Club meets in room D7 on Mondays. Go to room C9 Thursdays during lunch for the ASL Club. The Light Club meets every Thursday in rooms D5 and 6. Check it out, and maybe you'll learn how to walk on water. The Hesperia High School Democrats meet every Tuesday at lunch, room S17. They were going to have a guest speaker, but President Biden fell asleep again. Mock Trial meets in room N5, Wednesdays and Fridays at lunch. Check it out if you have nothing better to do. With that, assuming you haven't been on your phone for the last 12 minutes, we go to a 60-second documentary starring Gabriella from the dance team. Enjoy it if you feel like it.
Hi, my name is Gabriella Hernandez. I'm the lieutenant for the dance team for Hesperia High School. I love art. So I like to express however I feel in any type of way, and I think dance like really captures like the emotion I'm trying to bring out to the world, I guess. My mind just is blank. I'm at peace with myself. Nothing matters besides like me in that moment. As a dance lieutenant, I get to see more of like behind the scenes, ordering like dance shoes, preparing for our seniors, like senior night and all of that. I also get to create some of the dances we perform. I feel like when you're in like a club or like a group and you guys love one thing in particular, you guys really bond over that one thing, and then you guys find out what you have more in common later on. We do TikToks when we have the time. We collaborate and like we get in like a small circle and we just talk about who we are and get to know each other more on a personal level. Dance could be for anyone. You could learn any type of style. It's really not that hard. Anyone could do it. As long as you put in the work and the effort in, it should be easy for anyone.
Well, that's all, folks. I leave you now with another one of our signature oversaturated broadcast outros. For the record, you can turn it off now. We know you want to.
Proof that not everything can be an album cover.